Star Wars has R2-D2 and C-3PO. Pirates had Ewan McKenzie in a lot of ways. Can you talk a little bit about that and the responsibility fell as the kind of the comic relief of the series as it went along?
Well, absolutely. You know, and I think the key thing was that when McKenzie was cast first, and then I was cast out of Hollywood, and the first thing that Gore Verbinski, the director, gave us the responsibility to me of is like, go be that guy's best friend. That's what he told me. And so me and McKenzie started out, and it was kind of like opposites attract. The extrovert and the introvert became great friends. And we would hang out a lot and really have that contact that then translated onto the screen. And I think that was a lot of the, we really cared about each other as friends. You find that out. That's what layers the comedy. If they're just kind of nerdy kind of duos, but like C-3PO and R2-D2 care about each other. And that was the same for Pintel and Rigetti. That's why we made up the story that he was my nephew. Because otherwise it couldn't explain the relationship necessarily. It seemed like it might be kind of a bit non-Disney, if you will.
You were just trying to look after him.
Absolutely. I'm his uncle. It was like he was my sister's kid, and that was what we played. You know, basically, is that I was Uncle Abner. We made up, he was Terry Rigetti, I was Abner Pintel. We just created our own backstory to give us a reason, you know, why we would do some of the silly things, you know. And then we shared half a brain, right? The characters were not the smartest dudes, so that was part of it as well.